So thanks for talking to us. Obviously, you were out in the middle when it all started to happen. Was it a surprise? Obviously, you'd seen the run-ups beforehand, but did you expect that?
Yeah, to be honest with you, we did kind of expect it, but maybe not quite as soon. I think, we talked about it, and we might have said, given it a few more overs, but, I couldn't believe that the state it was in after even three or four balls.
Obviously, as a batter, you couldn't really contribute much to the decision, I don't suppose, but it seemed obvious that the West Indies bowlers were struggling with their run-up straight away.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. I mean, every time, we're setting ourselves to get delivered and the ball never came as they kind of ran through, and I think that's happened three or four times, and Jerome Taylor had to go around the wicket to avoid one hole he already made. So, that's not a great ideal state to play Test cricket, and you're right. I mean, I had no say. They had two captains. Obviously, Strauss was out there as well, so... That's really not really much point me putting my thoughts through.
But obviously a massive disappointment, not just for the team 1-0 down in the series, but also the spectators that have come out. It's pretty much the worst case scenario, isn't it?
Yeah, we as players, we're kind of lucky in the situation. We're here, we can go to Barbados and play if that's what happened. But obviously, I feel really sorry for all the spectators who spent a lot of money coming out. Hopefully, we can see some cricket in Antigua.
How do you sort of as a team cope? I suppose it's still not been a ban of the match. How do you keep yourself in a frame of mind possibly playing here tomorrow or somewhere else in the next couple of days?
Yeah, I mean, that's that is as you have to deal with the player. I mean, that's, obviously today the rest of the day is off and stuff, and you kind of get over what's happened. And then if we are here tomorrow, that's the duty of us players to make sure that we're fully focused at, 10 o'clock.
And obviously, as we mentioned, you were batting, but the England team's bowlers, you think, obviously, with tall bowlers and Ryan Sidebottom, the left arm as well, everyone would have struggled on that run-up.
Yeah, without doubt. It might have taken a few more overs, maybe. But I think, West Indies read the race probably quite early and saw he wasn't fit. And we might have done injuries if we'd have carried on. I could have only seen one thing happening, whoever was bowling.
That's the thing, the injuries are a real big concern. It's not just the run-ups, the outfield as well is pretty sandy. Was that something in the back of your players' minds?
Yeah, we were already told we weren't allowed to slide. That slide on it, we weren't allowed to do that with the medical staff. Well, not weren't allowed, but the very road that would do it. So, it's just not ideal, and, it's a bit of a shambles all around.
And just finally then, you obviously, now, whenever you play next, still one down the series, obviously hoping to somehow squeeze this second test in somewhere.
Yeah, I mean that's totally out of my control and all our players' control, and we just wait until the decision of that. And you're right, we're 1-0 down the series. We need to play cricket. We want to play cricket, and we've got to get back in the series. We're playing some good cricket.